And like, what you have to do is basically deny the person in first points and get as many points as you can for yourself. So you'll see that that is basically what I do in all my games. Sometimes, for example, the other day in one of my videos, you left me a comment saying, "Wow, so greedy." But the reason why I was greedy was precisely because I was not in the lead. That's precisely the point. When you're not in the lead, you have to be greedy because you need to catch up. You have to play catch up. But when you're in the lead, you don't necessarily have to be greedy. Like, you could, but you don't have to be. Yeah, 350 times 2 is good, but remember that AC is a time-based game. If there is a moment when your target is playing hard to get and is making you waste time, it is pointless to get 700 points if it takes you 2 minutes. In that case, it is better to get a rush kill for 150, 250 if necessary, and then just go for your next kill. Because you can get like a 150 in 20 seconds, and then in 50 seconds you can get a 700 point kill. In other words, you have to react accordingly to what your target is doing. If your target is playing hard to get, you have to pressure them and kill them. You cannot just let them run around. I mean, if you let them run around, you're done. What's gonna happen every time is that you're gonna get killed. Like, your pursuers are going to flank you while you're trying to get your own target, and you're gonna die, and your target is gonna get rid of a pursuer for free. So yeah, that is the whole point. I mean, you have to be aware of the time. Time matters, as many people don't like to admit. I mean, they think that it's like, oh, it's all about doing good kills. No, it's not about doing good kills. It's about doing a certain amount of points per unit of time. So if it takes you 5 years to get a good kill, it is pointless. Because in the meantime, your opponents are going to be scoring like crazy. So, yeah. Alright, let's do this. Let's go with the next lesson. So the next lesson was about... well, we could go with knives or with the abilities thing. Let's start with knives and the properties of knives. So, knives. Yeah, everyone's favorite ability, honestly. There's a reason to understand how knives work, because almost everyone is using knives, and for good reason. There's a reason for that, and it's that they work wonders, honestly, in terms of getting variety and other stuff. But let's start with knife knockdowns. Stop knifing me, please. So, knockdowns with knives. Depending on where you knife a person, it causes different states of knockdown. The most basic one is no knockdown. So, for example, put yourself here, Vanarai. Put yourself here. If your target is in a neutral position, meaning they're not in an acrobatic position or in some sort of pole, a neutral knockdown or no knockdown basically is this. When they get hit by knife, they kind of like bend over like that. That's no knockdown. It doesn't really have any special property besides freezing your target in place for a little bit. And they can still activate droppable abilities, namely smoke bomb, firecrackers, time phase, anything that's droppable basically. They can also use bodyguard. In this regard, let's say that bodyguard is a droppable ability. And yeah, let's do that. I'll knife you and you drop smoke bomb, Vanarai, alright? Or whatever. If you have firecrackers, you use firecrackers. Here I go. Yeah. So it is very important to understand that if you're going to counter knives, the ability that you use to counter knives, it has to be a droppable ability. Like, you cannot use these guys against knives. I mean, it wouldn't be useful anyway, but let me think about something else, something that's not droppable. Okay, knives. Let's take knives themselves. You cannot activate knives when you get hit by knives. Why? Because knives is not a droppable ability. So you have to wait in order to use it before, until your character stops being bended over. Therefore, knives is not a good counter to knives. Not is disruption, nor is sabotage, obviously. So yeah, the counters to knives are firecrackers, time phase, and smoke bomb for the most part. And out of these three, only smoke bomb is a real, like, situation-independent counter, because both time phase and firecrackers are reliant on the fact that there are civilians around you for you to be able to get the stun. Therefore, if you get knife on a rooftop like here, like, smoke bomb is the only ability that can save you. Time phase is gonna do nothing, firecrackers is gonna do nothing. And it is the same for this is especially obvious when you're knifed on a ledge like this. Well, here you will get fucked because it's up fitting the air position. But let's do it here, for example. Put yourself on the ledge. So for example, if I knife you there, don't grab. No, that's you will die there, because when you fall, I have enough time to either climb over here and jump over here. So yeah, I can kill you in a million ways there. But get on top, get on top again. All right, so if you get knifed there, there is literally only one way you can save yourself, and that is a smoke bomb. And that is reliant on the fact that I don't have shield. If I do have shield, you're still fucked. But yeah, let's do that. Although we did show it in the last training session, but let's do it again. Here we go. Yeah, so essentially smoke bomb is the only ability that can protect you from a grab kill. And also in general, it is the only ability that can reliably protect you from knives. So let's do it here, for example. Let's do it on the ground now, instead of a grab kill position. Okay, so this is something very important about the metagame of knives. How people use knives. Most people don't use knives and rush kill you. No, they don't do that. Most people knife you because they want to get a good kill on you. They want to stop you. So basically what they're gonna do most of the time is that they're gonna knife you and go into a blend group or similar and try walking at you. This is exactly the type of situation that you want to have to stun them with smoke bomb. Smoke bomb is not really good against rushing pursuers because smoke bomb has a delay. Therefore, the idea is to use it mostly when you get knifed. Smoke bomb is the counter to knives, essentially. Doesn't mean it will work every time, but it can work reliably most of the time. You and your trolling. Alright, so let's do that. I'll do it again as if I was going to kill you. Start walking away from me and I'm going to knife you. So yeah, like that. Okay, so for example, I have many options there. I can see the smoke bomb come out and I can just go back, but you can always choose to run away. So in that sense, smoke bomb does save you, much unlike Time Phase or Firecrackers. Now I want you to do the same, but I want you to use Firecrackers this time. All right, so here I go. Okay, so since I am a good player, I will always try to knife you when you're not in the middle of civilians. I'm not dumb. Obviously, if I knife you in the middle of civilians, I'm giving you an additional option of deploying firecrackers and making me miss by killing a civilian. So if I am going to use knives, I will always scout you so that I knife you when you're not near civilians. So yeah, or so that civilians are left behind. Yeah, for example, this time I'm scared of killing because there is a civilian in the way. But I can always, if you think I'm going to knife you, or if you're blending along civilians, one option I have is I can do a fiend. Because if you think I'm going for you, then this is another way of dealing with firecrackers, by the way. So for example, I can do this. Like, okay, I'm going for you, and when you drop FC, I just back out, and then I can knife you after that. Works a lot. Another thing I can do is knife you just as you drop firecrackers. This will make you not be able to move, and you won't be able to do anything about it, because, I mean, you'll have to stay in place, and I can just kill you after the firecracker vanishes. So let's do that. I'll go for the kill now with the knife. No, you're not gonna stun me there. That's not gonna work. So, oh, oops, release it. I just released. I need to be your pursuer. So yeah, here we go. Your target has exposed you. Whoa, the lag is real, Vanarai. The lag is very real. You were not even close. You were not even close, seriously. I couldn't even have anticipated. From where I knife you, it made no sense how you stunned me, because you were not even closer to me. By the way, it's pretty easy when you're already anticipating that they're gonna knife you, but it's not as easy when you're in an actual game, because you don't know what they're gonna do. I mean, it's pretty easy here because you know it, but what about when you don't know it and you just get knifed? Here, you're actively trying to look for civilians to be close to you, but I mean, in an actual game, it just isn't like that. Not if you don't know that I'm gonna knife you. Alright, so let's do it. Let me lock you. Where are you? Okay, so here we go. This is the example of what I was saying of knifing at the same time. Here I go. Your target has exposed you. Yeah, so that's how it works. When you knife them, their movement options are limited. So if you knife them exactly as you make the semi-fiend, because it's not a fiend, it's not an actual fiend, because you're not turning back, but because you kind of like rush into them and then suddenly stop, it's sort of a fiend. And obviously, if I knife you here, Vanarai, if I knife you here, you're done. I mean, firecrackers are useless for you here. You're done there. I mean, you're gonna die for sure. Because, like, even though there are civilians around, they're just not in the way. So I can kill you pretty easily. Yeah, successful firecrackers are when you run. But if the other person also runs and knives you exactly as you drop firecrackers, they are useless. Because the knives are last longer than the firecrackers. And you're not gonna be able to move even after the firecrackers are over. So, yeah. Anyway, back to what we were saying about knives. Let's go again with knives, knockdowns, because this is actually about knives and not firecrackers. But yeah, it's good to know that. By the way, did you know, this is just a little detail before we move on. Did you know that firecrackers are brighter on raining maps? For example, if it's raining, firecrackers shine a lot brighter. Brighter. Have you noticed that, for example, In what's the map? In St. Pierre, it happens a lot, but it's not because it's St. Pierre. It's because in St. Pierre, it is raining a lot. I mean, usually it is raining. But for example, right now here, I can show it to people. Like, let's show it right now. Get over here. Right now it's raining. So this is a good moment to notice it. Drop firecrackers here in front of me. Well, actually, it is not as blinding. Maybe it does have a bit to do with the map as well. But they are certainly brighter when it is raining. For example, in St. Pierre, if it's not raining, they are not as bright. So the rain has something to do with it. But oh well. Yeah, that's just for general knowledge. Let's go with knives again. Over here. Alright, let's do this. So we already said about no knockdown. That is no knockdown. Let's go that now with acrobatic knockdown. So an acrobatic knockdown happens when you're in an acrobatic position. And the thing about an acrobatic knockdown is that depending on how high you fall, there's going to be an even bigger stun when you fall down. But the stun itself is already like pretty good if you fall from an average height. For example, knock me down from here. Yeah, this is an acrobatic knockdown. When you're knocked down from an acrobatic position, it's gonna fall like that. You're gonna be stunned a few seconds below, leaving you completely vulnerable. And unlike a no knockdown, when you get knocked down like this, you cannot activate abilities. So, for example, try activating something there. You can't. You can't activate anything. Yeah, you can only activate it after you're standing. But while you're on the ground, you cannot activate anything, thus making you vulnerable even for a regular kill. Without contest. So for example, yeah, go up top so I can knock you down. I'll try to kill you and I want you to drop whatever you... No, climb on the other one, please. On the higher one. Alright. Here we go. So yeah, for example, I can kill you here for free. You can even contest. I could have gotten a hidden. If there was a civilian nearby, I could have gotten a hidden. No, you can't. No, oh, please try. Please try, by all means. I want you to mash a square. So, yeah, get on top of that. Your target has exposed you. Oh, actually, it does contest. Maybe I was wrong then. Alright. Alright, yeah, I guess I was wrong then. Maybe I misremember that. But, yeah. Yeah, hiddens don't always work out, but at least I guess you can get acrobatics for free. Because when they fall like that, I mean, they cannot activate knives or anything. So you can, like, climb into an acro position near them. And you'll get an easy acro. I'll do that. I'll do that now. For example, I'll knock you down. And I climb over here. Yeah, I can get a focus from here. And now is the moment that you can throw knives, so I can just get the focus for free there. Yeah, it's really, really important to use acrobatic knockdowns to your advantage whenever you see your target is either on a pole or something like that. By the way, acrobatic knockdowns only happen on top of poles. They don't happen for hanging from the ledge. So yeah, if you're hanging on the ledge, it doesn't cause an acrobatic knockdown. Now, there is something important we have to talk about, and it's about getting knifed and using the invincibility of rolls for escaping knives. I want to show you something. So the thing is, if you get knocked down from a ledge, like try knocking me down here. Knife me, please. Where I am. Alright, so usually when I fall, it doesn't cause an acrobatic knockdown. It causes a no knockdown. The thing is, when it causes a no knockdown and you fall from a given height, well, that given height is this. I'll show you here. This is a good place to demonstrate it. Get over here where I am. Okay, wait. Oh, shit. Okay, so do you see the exact height I am right now? If you knife me here, when I fall down, I have the chance of rolling like this. So you have to be careful of not knifing people above chase breakers, because they can escape by using a roll. Normally I do this, I put myself on top of chase breakers to bait people into knifing me, because I know they're gonna knife me. So I put myself here, for example, I want you to knife me, and I escape through here. Yeah, so... And there's another important thing about it, there's absolutely no frames during your fall where you are vulnerable to dying, because rolls are invincible in this game. Just like instant drops, rolls, like the frames of rolling, are invincible. And this holds true for ACR, AC3, and AC4. In ACB, rolls are not invincible. So when you are rolling, you can get killed. Unlike here. And I'll show you that right now. I'm gonna roll somewhere. Where can I roll? That you can kill me. I want you to see that the prompt doesn't show up while I am rolling. Let me see what is a good place. We can do it here. So, for example, put yourself on top of me. Knife me, and I'll roll forward. So, yeah, do you see that while I was rolling, you didn't see the prompt? Like, there's no prompt above my head while I am rolling. That's because the rolls are invincible, precisely. And that is precisely the reason why you shouldn't knife someone who is on top of a chase breaker, because they might roll into it, invincible, and thus you're gonna waste your knives. So yeah, don't do that. Okay, so about acrobatic knockdowns, there's another important thing. The way that people fall on acrobatic knockdowns is deterministic. In other words, you can always know where they are going to fall just by looking at their position. And the key to this is that people are always going to fall on their back. Not necessarily on their back, but to the side that their back is. For example, let me put myself here. If I put myself here and you knife me, see how it knocks me down back, right? Like I fell on my back. I'm gonna go up top and I'm going to look to the other side now. So yeah, knife me there. You see, it knocks me down on this side. It's pretty important to know where is your target going to fall when you knife them, because that can help you, like, move in advance, like, anticipate their fall and position yourself for the kill earlier than you could have done otherwise. Therefore, you can get save some time. Let me give you an example. Put yourself where I was before. And I want you to look to this side. Alright, so if you look over here, I know you're gonna fall over on the other side. So if I knife you, my best course of action for getting an acrobatic kill is possibly either jumping like this. I mean, wait. Jumping like this, like hanging from here. This is possibly my best course of action when you fall. But if I know you're going to fall over there, then I can just do it immediately as soon as I hit you with the knife. Like... You see, you barely even got to the bottom and I already... For example, I got a full focus 350 there because of that, because I jumped in advance. I knew you were gonna fall there, so I just jumped where I knew I was gonna kill you. Yep. That's too deep. It's not so deep when you already know it. Oh no, I totally think about this during the match. Of course. The difference is I have practiced it so many times, it just comes natural to me. I already know when you're gonna fall before I even knife you. So, I mean, it's all part of the plan. For people who are new to it, of course, it's not gonna be natural because you haven't mastered the skill. But for me, it is natural. I already know this. And let's see, let's do something else. Okay, so put yourself there, and I want you to look to the other side now. To away from me instead of over here. Okay, so if you're like that, I know you're gonna fall on this side. If you're gonna fall on this side, I have various options. I could put myself here to get an acro, but the problem is if I put myself here, I make myself vulnerable to an acrobatic knockdown from my pursuer. Like, they can knife me and knock me down. And if that happens, I'm gonna lose the kill. You cannot knife me, so forget about the fact you can knife me. You're gonna be knocked down, so you cannot do anything. Forget about knocking me down. But my pursuers can knock me down, so I don't want to put myself in a vulnerable position. So what I'm gonna do instead is, since I know you're gonna fall here, I'm gonna put myself here and look down like this, and I'm gonna feel focused. And then when the meter is full, or when I feel happy about how many points I'm gonna get, I'm gonna hang from here and instantly get the kill. The reason why I'm going to do it that way is because that way I can get the acrobatic with minimal risk of getting knocked down. Or another thing I could do is, if I am here, when I got the focus on whatever points I want to get, I jump over here, and that's gonna be an acro as well. And it's gonna be pretty quick. So I can choose either, depending on where my pursuers are. Okay, so look over there. Look away from me. Let me release so I can start without the meter. Alright, here we go. So here you come. You fall. I don't have to jump anywhere because I know you're gonna fall here. I feel happy. I hang. And there you go. Acrobatic 350 focus. So yeah, it can be pretty relevant knowing that. It can help you get a few extra points. And that's that. Now there is one more type of knockdown besides... Oh, by the way, I forgot to say something. Well, I actually said it, but I'll repeat it. How much you stay knocked down depends on how far do you fall from. So, for example, if you fall from here, this is gonna be an acrobatic knockdown as well. Put yourself here, actually. Yeah, put yourself in this one. So, if I knock you down from there, notice... Oh, you did... Look at that. It wasn't even, like, a heavy knockdown. It wasn't a hard knockdown. If you get knocked down from this height, it is a hard knockdown. But if I knock you down from there, because you fall on the stairs, and the stairs are slightly higher than the ground over here... Yeah, it was pretty obvious there. Let's do it again. Let's do it again. But don't drop firecrackers, please, because I cannot see. So, yeah. All right, so let's try knifing each other at the same time. One, two, three. Oh, you're two. Yeah, I guess there's a lag after all. But let's try it again. All right, so one, two, three. Oh, my gosh. Again. I'll try to be slower this time, I guess. One, two, three. There we go. Alright, so look at me. I get hard knockdowns, and you only get normal knockdown. Because where you fell is higher than where I fell. So I fell from a higher distance. And the distance is what determines the type of knockdown that you get. When it comes to acrobatic knockdowns, that is. Let me give you the example of the highest place in this map. Get over here, Vanarai. For example, I want you to knock me down from here. It's gonna take years for me to get up. Bam! So you see, it's like a fell sleep there. So it takes pretty long depending on the height. But there is a height that there is a limit, of course. There is a height that anything higher than that, it basically stuns you for the same amount of time. But yeah, height matters in any case. Alright, so that is acrobatic knockdowns. There's just one more type of knockdown that we have to talk about. And that is a ledge knockdown. So a ledge knockdown happens when you either jump on a ledge or when you climb to the top of a ledge and you get knifed exactly as you get as you reach the top of the ledge. For example, I want you to knife me as I get to the top of this. Get down here. Get down here. Whoa. Alright, so I want you to knife me as I am going to get to the top of that little rooftop there. Oh, shit. Whoa, whoa. That was an accident. Alright, Okay, so here I go. Alright, so that is an acrobatic knockdown, essentially. It does not happen if the person is already on the ledge. It only happens if they are almost getting to the ledge. And the reason why it happens is because when you are just getting to the ledge, you are in an acrobatic position, as we stated before. That's why you get an acrobatic when you mash the button while climbing a wall. So let me get on here. Yeah, you see, it didn't happen there because I was already on top. But if you knife them more or less exactly as they are getting to the top, then you'll get an acrobatic ledge knockdown. Okay, so ledge knockdowns have a very interesting property, which is not useful at all times, but it can be at times. And it is that you can slightly control the direction of your fall during the ledge knockdown. Let me show you how is this useful. Let's get over here. Alright, so I want you to knife me as I get to the top of this little block over here. And then I want you to possibly kill me. But I'll show you, I'll try to escape by controlling the direction of my fall. And using the invincibility of rolling to my advantage. So it's pretty hard to do, so I might not get it on the first try, but let's try it. Alright, so here I go. Too early. Too early. Whoa, wait, whoa. You're supposed to knife me as I get to the top. Whoa, that was so early. I mean, obviously it's not like you're always gonna get knifed like this, but when you do, you have the option to control the direction of your fall. So let's do that. Alright, oh shit, my hands hurt a bit. Let me just relax my right hand a bit. Alright, here we go, let's do it. Yep, so, do you see that? Do you see what I just did? Obviously, you have to be close to the ledge. Yeah, it has to be pretty calculated, but the thing is, sometimes it happens, and I mean, better than not trying anything and just getting grab killed, you might as well try. I mean, in this case, of course, I was prepared for it, but I also did this in a video. I did this in a video in an actual game, and some people told me, like, wow, how did you control your fall? How do you just, like, make yourself fall into there? And it's obviously because I have practiced it. I mean, obviously you're not just gonna improvise this on the fly. It's something you have to be aware of to actually put into practice in games. But it can save your ass at times, if you know how to do it. But yeah, it's obviously very situational. It's something that will only be useful like one out of every 1,000 times. Now, the one time where it is useful, your pursuer will be mind-fucked. Literally. They will be like, what the actual fuck? Are you serious? They won't believe you just did that. Alright, so yeah, that's when it comes to knockdown types. Yep, that's about it for knives. Did I forget something? No, I don't think so. I think we basically covered everything, the direction of falls and that. Oh yeah, well, there's one more thing that some people don't know, and is that when you knock down your target from an acrobatic position or from any kind of position, if they intercept you when they are falling, they're gonna knock you down as well. So you have to be very careful to climb from a direction where the target doesn't fall on top of you. Let's try getting that. It's pretty rare, but it does happen, in fact. So let's try doing that over here somewhere. Where is a good place to do this? Oh, yeah, I think we can do it here. For example, get over here. So, get over here. Drop down. Alright, so for example here, I want you to, as I climb this little object and I get to the top, I want you to knife me. And I want you to climb more or less around the same place where I climbed, alright? To see if I fall on top of you and it knocks you down. So let's do that. Oh, what happened? That was so slow, Vanarai. That was so slow. I actually even jumped. So let's do it again. Yeah, I know it is small, but that is the whole point, that you get quickly to where I am. Let's do it again. You have to anticipate me to knife me, though. You can't be so late. So, yeah, I'll come running from a distance to give you a better hint of when am I going to get to the block. So, here I go. Too early. Alright, let's do it again. Alright, I'll do it. You climb here, okay? No, okay, you climb there, alright? I want you to climb this part of the block where I am right now. And then I'll climb right after you. Let's do it. Alright, go ahead. You see? There it is. You see? You knocked me down. You see? It is not small enough. It can actually happen even there. That's what I was trying to show you before, that the other person can fall on top of you. In some cases. And if they knock you down from a really high place, it's gonna knock you down exactly as if you got knifed from that specific place. So in other words, it can cause a hard knockdown. If they fall on top of you and you fall from a very high place, it's gonna cause a hard knockdown on you. Yeah, that happens. And you have to be careful about it. Some people talking to me. Yo, Mr. NovaMage, how you doing? Could I request your help if you have 3 free minutes between your games? Thanks in advance. It's concerning the ports, can play in CMP. Oh, sure, but right now training someone. Yeah, oh, sure, but right now training someone. I'll help you in a while. So, yeah. Hi, Nova. Let me advise DM. Not right now. A few people asking me to play. Okay, so there's one more thing we have to do. And after that, we'll be done, basically. The last lesson is actually pretty easy, and most of it is just, like, strategy rather than actual information. Because up till now, I've actually been telling you new things, in most cases, like stuff you didn't know. But in this case, it's probably stuff you already know. It's just a different way of looking at things, perhaps. The game session is